already seen history made and records broken in the long throw finals at the Paris 2024 Olympic Games. And the action continues as the spotlight is on the men's javelin final. A field that's full of talent and features the reigning champion, the 2012 gold medalist, two former world champions and multiple global medalists scattered amongst them. But only one will be crowned Olympic champion here in Paris. Every seat filled once again here in the stunning Stade de France, this 80,000 capacity cauldron, anticipating another high quality field final. Olympian Carrie Tollefson alongside myself, Ellen Ellarden. Carrie, the field of events have well and truly delivered so far, and these fans have been loving it.
They have. I mean, every single event is super fun right now. They're all performing. There's a lot of devastation out there too, which is the Olympic Games, right? But it's been really cool to see the highs of the highs, and yes, the field events have not disappointed at all.
Well and truly delivered a mix there. Some traditional French.
It has been so fun. The stadium is like a big carnival.
It's been so good. The atmosphere has been great for, well, the last 2.5 weeks. Rugby sevens were in before, and now it's the turn of the athletics, and we're flying through the program. Well, there is Mr. Consistent himself, Jakob Vadlaik. He's looking to make it 4 medals from 4 consecutive global championships. Chopra as well going for the same feat. It just shows really how consistent particularly these two have been over the course of the last 3 years.
Yeah, I mean, it seems as if they just keep getting better and better, and a lot of times that happens when you get to meet up and have these competitors. You know, you want to call them rivals, but a lot of times, especially in the throws, they're like brothers. They're not necessarily rivals. They're just wanting to help each other be the best they can be, and guess what? That helps them be the best that they can be.
So much talent on show. 5 of the top 6 in the world here. And while no one has thrown over 90 meters this season, there's so much talent, global accolades scattered amongst these 12 men that we'll be in for a great final and a really tight competition, you feel, regardless of whether we hit the 90-meter mark, which we would love to see tonight.
Well, I think it's really fun that this competition is so tight. I mean, there's some big names, right, that we know of and that seem to always kind of shine and get through, but we've seen it time and time again here where we have a newbie that steps up and just launches one or has one of their best races of their life. So, again, this is the Olympic Games. This is what happens. You know, you think about every 4 years this meet comes around, a lot can happen. I was thinking about my daughter, for instance. She's going into the 9th grade. She will be going into college the next time around. Like, so much will happen, yep. But yet they seem like they come around fast. So I think it's going to be exciting to see if we have a big name, a big favorite, or if we have a new name, because this can happen.
We've seen plenty of changings of the guards over the course of the last few days here, particularly when we've been focused on the field finals, and that is of course the focus tonight, the men's javelin throw final here in the glorious Stade de France as the sun begins to set over this incredible stadium. It really is such an architectural work of art and is housing, well, so many fans sporting so many different colors, all anticipating another big final. We've seen Olympic records fall. Could we see that happen again tonight? We'd need a throw over 90 meters if it's to happen, but plenty of the men in this field capable of that. And we're hoping that they've timed their peak for exactly the right time and this men's javelin final tonight.
Well, this is much like what it looks like when you go into the village and you sit in the cafeteria. You see people of all shapes and sizes from everywhere, of all ethnicities. That's one of my favorite things about talking about being an Olympian is when you go and you go to the different venues in the village, you see people that are the best in the world and they all look different. There's not one size fits all here. It is, everybody is good at what they do with the body they've been given, and it's really cool. I love that aspect of the Olympics.
Well, a lovely shot there of the Stade de France, on both the outside and the inside. We're waiting for the start of the men's javelin final. The athletes have gone through their final preparations. They've been escorted back down the tunnel that you can see on the right-hand side of your screen, just past the first 100 meters and the end of that bend. And there are the implements that these men will be using tonight.
I think those are pretty shots. Like last night we saw the discus and it was just this, you know, all the discs were in a row and it was really pretty. I think that's really pretty too. But I'm a sap for athletics, so.
So there it is, the Olympic record, 90 meters, 57. Well, there are athletes in this field who are capable of that. They'll need to be performing at their best today if they're to hit that mark. And there's a look at the start list. Neera Chopra, the reigning champion, back to try and achieve the double. It's been done plenty of times before in this competition, in this discipline. And let's meet the athletes as they come out of the tunnel. Luis Malizio da Silva, the South American bronze medalist and national record holder of Brazil, jogging out his Olympic debut. National record coming in qualifying. Lassi Etelatalo of Finland, one of three Finnish athletes in this field. Julius Yego of Kenya, former world champion and 2016 silver medalist, now 35 years old. Season's best though, coming in qualifying. He's coming into this in good form. 85-27 PB qualifying for Finland, Tony Kerenen. Personal best set in qualifying for Tony Kerenen. His first global final. And the gold medalist from 2012, Kershaw Walcott, did the quite incredible double that year, winning the World Under 20 Championships in the same summer. Bronze medalist in 2016 as well. Adrian Madara of Moldova making his way out onto the track. Arshad Nadeem of Pakistan, world silver medalist, national record holder. Fifth in Tokyo, he'll be looking to find his way onto the podium this time round in Paris. Oliver Hellander of Finland. Twice a world champion for Grenada, Anderson Peters. Didn't make it out of qualifying in Tokyo in the 2020 games. He's in the final here and looking to find his way onto a podium. Julian Weber of Germany, his third Olympic final. He was fourth in Tokyo, ninth in 2016. After missing out in Tokyo, I'm sure he'd love to have some silverware hung around his neck this time out. Jakub Vadlajc of Czechia, Mr. Consistent, silver medalist in Tokyo, medalled at three of four of the last World Championships. Neera Chopra, the reigning champion, out onto the track. Twice an Asian Games champion, he's the reigning world champion as well. And that gold medal coming on debut last time out. He's looking to defend it here in Paris.
23 years old when he did that. First man from India to win Olympic gold. And he has 9 million followers.
His story is such an inspiration, and I think that sums up just how popular he is in his home country of India. It's incredible, isn't it? The impact that he's had on sport. He's already seen as one of the greats. And, well, there'll be 9 million plus rallying him on. I'm trying to will him onto the double. Some final preparations. All the athletes sort of splitting off into their individual areas. It will be Jakub Vadlajc. First we go in the javelin into the Olympics, silver medalist for Czechia, Jakub Vadlajc.
by the world record holder. It's kind of a cool thing to have.
So the silver medalist from Tokyo getting us underway here in Paris. How can he open up his series? Just over 80 meters. Oh, the season's best of 88.65 and a personal best of over 90 meters.
Look at how close he is. But he has to be pleased just to get one out there. You know, so many times in this game, we haven't seen a lot of real good first throws. We saw it in the men's hammer. That was basically the only one. But there's been some upsets because of not getting a mark on the board. He's got his mark on the board now.
It will take a lot of confidence if you can throw down a really good first marker. Anderson Peters with a season's best coming in qualifying.
He round into shape a little bit. He's been injured the past year. Doesn't have the best of luck, but this is the time to get your health back and to get ready to go. Throw your biggest throw or throws of the season.
He'll be remembering how much it hurt in Tokyo not to make it through qualifying. He's gone on to reclaim his world title since that. He did it in 2022. And for another global podium and global title here in Paris. And that's a much better start. Just short of 85 meters.
That's exactly where he wants to be. Javelin, you want to be about 30 degrees for your angle, and he was right there, 32 degrees of an angle. So just a little bit, let it float. Get that tip down, although you don't have to stick it in the grass. You need to just let it hit tip first.
84 meters 70 for Anderson Peters.
Story about watching YouTube to learn how to throw.
Keshan Walcott of Trinidad and Tobago. Two-time medalist, and he's into the lead. Early stages, and he's happy with that marker that he's laid down.
Speed really opened up there. Look at that. Ooh, so much core control. Looks pretty pleased.
We'll be happy with that marker that sees him into the lead. Very early stages. They'll take confidence from that 86 meters and 16 throw, a season's best for Walcott, and that's why he was celebrating. Just under a meter, he's improved his season's best by. Good time to do it as well here in the final of the Olympic Games men's javelin throw. Arshad Nadeem on the runway. And he's going to take that one back. Wasn't happy with it. You can see the clock ticking, and he'll be allowed within that time as many attempts to go forward as long as he doesn't cross the line or release the javelin.
Happy with that run up. I don't think it's not enough speed to really get the momentum he needed.
Something not clicking there. The man who was fifth in Tokyo, a world silver medalist. He's thrown over 90 meters in his lifetime. Feat yet to be achieved by this man, Julian Weber of Germany.
Diamond League win this season, which is new for him. Has never won one, so he's got to be excited about that.
He's experienced here in Olympic finals. So get his hands on any Olympic silverware, though. Oh, that was close to the line, and it will be a red flag. We've seen across the field events, particularly the long throws, the officials very hot on foot faults and making sure the athletes are staying within their bounds. So a no throw for Julian Weber of Germany, ranked number 3 in the world, and he'll have to come back searching for something big in the second round. 200 meters, Olympic final. It's the finale of the 200 meters. Diego of Kenya, some final stretches as he waits for the action on the track to get underway. He's gone over 90 metres. He's gone quite significantly over 90 metres. 92.72, but that was back in 2015. He's a silver medalist in 2016.
I can see a bit of a brace on his left ankle. I believe he sprained his ankle pretty bad at the Kip Kano Classic in April. So just trying to manage that. It's tough to have those setbacks in an Olympic year. You know, mentally almost more so. You've been working so hard, you think not, can't have anything wrong, but more times than not, most athletes at the Olympic Games are just hanging on by a thread. They're seeing a lot of athletic trainers, a lot of chiropractors, massage therapists, all the people that can keep them together.
All the best people in the world. Not just the athletes, the top talent when it comes to physiotherapists, chiropractors, those helping, supporting the athletes to keep them in peak physical shape are here at the Paris Olympic Games. I'm sure these athletes are ready to go. Julius Yego finally on the runway now. A long run up for the Kenyan. A high looping throw after that swallow dive, and just over 80 meters.
Yeah, I'm wondering where it was that it's. I think the stumble just came by the force that came with that throw. Stayed within boundaries. Waiting on that.
Wait for confirmation of the measurement.
Just waiting to see.
80.29 for Julius Yego.
Okay, he's on the board.
Taylor Talo of Finland. Three of the Finnish athletes making it through to the final here in Paris. Heavy strapping on the arms of Lasse Etelialo. And you would have wanted more from that, not over 80 metres.
Took up the sport when he was 10 years old. He's been in it for a long time. Now he is self-coached. How do you go back and kind of regroup now? You know, you got to get your mind in it. You got to figure out what went wrong. He doesn't have that person to go to look at that replay unless there is somebody that he's kind of put in that position. I guess he's watching on the big screen here. Regroup.
78.81 is the mark for the athlete from Finland. And here's the reigning champion from India. He'll want to lay down a marker. A statement throw is what he'll want in the first round here of the men's javelin final. Far from going over that 90-metre mark in qualifying. Not too happy with that.
Just a bit of a slip right there. Good run-up, but just so much force. Yep.
So it will be a no throw. We didn't even see where the javelin ended up.
So interesting. You know, you're giving it everything you've got. A lot of these athletes want to get those big throws out of the way as when they're fresh and not fatigued.
Adrian Madala of Moldova. Athlete just falling short of that 80 meter mark.
Getting it out there, getting a good snap of it, but just not what he wanted. Coach just kind of waved that one off. You know what? Let's just move on. We got it out there, just move on. Don't dwell on it. I think a lot of athletes can dwell on things, and the best thing to do is just to sort of get back in the ring, get going again, and see what you can do the next time.
You'll have to. Oliver Hollander. So best of 89-83.
Of a controlled fall there for him.
We see quite a few of the athletes opting for this swallow dive, and well, a little bit flatter in terms of the trajectory than what we've seen from the other athletes. It'll be 81 meters, maybe just a little bit over for Hollander. 81.24, enough to see him up into third, with just two more athletes to throw in this first round. Luis Mauricio da Silva. Watching that all the way down, and it's just over 80 meters.
Watching and praying, almost like just willing that jab to go just a little further every single time.
80-67, and we yet carry really to see a statement throw. Kashion Walcott with a season's best, 86-16, leads the way. Three no throws as well. Rannan of Finland, in his first global final, his first Olympic Games. It's my best set in qualifying. And he continued the good form here. You can see on his face there, nowhere near the mark that he set in qualifying, but something to improve on as he manages to keep his shoes just the right side of the line. Well, a tentative start for the athletes. 80-92 for Toni Kiranen of Finland. And a real mixed bag. And that means a wide open final.
For sure, you know, coming into the stadium, it is loud. It is right, there's so much going on, and sometimes just getting into the rhythm, getting into the feel of the competition, and I think we've seen that a few times here, especially on the infield there. You know, the runners come out, they do their deal, they get out. There's a lot of different noises, and they're out here for a lot longer, so they've got to kind of go with the ebbs and flows of what the crowd is doing. And so now they've gotten through that. time to get serious and get some big throws in.
First round out of the way. Hopefully some nerves settled. Some cobwebs blown away.
They can use as much or as little of this runway. It's sometimes interesting to see athletes go into the second lane, or they use the entire nine lanes in this case on this track.
A bad like of Czechia. And that's a big improvement on his first throw.
He had good control there as you watch him come through. I think he should be pretty pleased with that throw. An improvement is an improvement.
He'll climb his way up the order. And he's up into the bronze medal position. Very early stages of this men's javelin final. But a big improvement and things moving in the right direction for someone who we see is so consistent. And well, here's Anderson Peters of Grenada on the runway. Sat in second, looking for an improvement on 84 meters 70. Oh, that's nice. That's more like it. It will be an improvement for Anderson Peters, and it will be one that will see him into the lead.
Yeah, he has to be pleased with that one. You know, he goes to Mississippi State University, where he got his degree, there in business management. He's a great student, great guy of the sport. And look at that focus. There isn't a lot of emotion there. He is all in right now. He needs to be pleased with that.
What we've seen is it's flashes up as 87-87. We've seen on a number of occasions at this Olympic Games that sometimes it's a big throw, a big jump, something in one of the first or second rounds that wins it. You get the feeling in the early stages of this men's javelin throw final that it's going to be something we build towards, some kind of crescendo. But here's the man looking to retain his top spot, Wolcott. Can he get back on top here? Not to be. Doesn't make it over 80 metres. And the red flag shown regardless. Still has a good marker in the bank though, Carrie.
Definitely, and that's what those big ones do. They give you a little bit of cushion just in case things go wrong. We'll have to see now. This first throw wasn't what he wanted. The run-up wasn't good. He went back. Nadim here needs to get a big one out there.
He does. Things just weren't clicking for him in terms of the run-up and those early processes. Nadim, the world silver medalist from last summer. Arshed Nadim. That's better. It's huge. It's a great throw, and it will surely be a new Olympic record. Well, what a change in terms of demeanor. He could barely complete his run-up on the first throw, and that is massive from Arshed Nadim. A new Olympic record, 92 meters, 97. Arshed Nadim of Pakistan, a huge throw in the second round to take the lead. The world silver medalist laying down the marker that the athletes will have to chase if they're to take the gold medal out of his grasp.
Look at that, hand in his, head in his hands. Just can't even believe it, but wow, what a brilliant throw he just had.
And it's a massive personal best as well. He'd thrown 90 meters 18. He hadn't thrown over 87 meters this season. So a season's best of 80 of well over 5 meters.
92.
It's huge.
0.97, amazing.
So much for this becoming a bit of a battle towards a crescendo. Nadim has laid down a huge marker in the second round. How does Julian Weber respond? Plenty of Olympic final experience. It's not bad as well. It's not bad. A no throw in the first round. Yep. And is this the start of Weber getting into his groove here?
I think that's what it takes. It takes a big throw. We saw that last night in the men's discus. And this is what happens. Everybody gets excited. And he still looks like he's got a little bit of disappointment, but it's better than it was. The competition has begun.
It has become. It was a tentative start. And we are now moving in this men's javelin final here at the Paris 2024 Olympic Games. Former world champion, Julius Yego of Kenya. Looking to improve on 80.29. It's good. That's better. Well, that throw from Nadim has really sparked some life into this competition. Julius Yego, that'll be a big improvement. Arshad Nadim has laid down the marker, and these athletes are responding. Yego, 87.72 into third. Well, it's tight, three athletes second down to fourth in the top end of 80 metres, 87 metres even. Season's best as well for Julius Yego. Taylor Talo of Finland. Still struggling to get over 80 metres. And when we see the throws in the second round that have gone before him, he won't want to let the competition get away from him, and it now leaves a lot of work to do in the third round to avoid that cut.
For sure. And, you know, he has been here before. He is a two-time Olympic competitor, so he knows the drill. He knows that he needs to react, and he needs to be at the top of his game. There's a little bit of disappointment there, just kind of thinking about, what am I doing? What do I need to fix? How do I calm myself and just get in this competition?
Big response needed here from Nila Chopra.
He's super tight with Nadim. They are very good friends, so you know he's going to hopefully react and get one out there as well.
He's going to need to if he wants to retain his title here in Paris. The reigning Olympic champion needs something huge, and that won't be it. It's an improvement. He had a no throw in the first round.
Looking at that. But for him to be nodding at the crowd, he's there. He's on. He's pumped. You can see the focus. I love that. The snap he had looked good. He just needed a little bit more strength behind it. Maybe a little bit more speed. But he knows what he's doing.
Well, he's never thrown over 90 meters. He'll need to if he's to retain his title. Modala of Moldova on the runway. One of 26 Moldovan athletes competing across 10 sports. They've already won two bronze medals.
A little too much height there.
It will be an improvement. Just sneaking over 80 meters, 80 meters and 10 for Modale. Lander of Finland currently occupying that eighth space. which particularly in the next round of throws really comes into play as we lose four of the athletes and progress with just the top eight. Helanda looking to move out that nervy eighth spot. His best before, 81.24. So there will be an improvement.
Quite what he wanted, though. Turned around, see. Regroup, figure it out.
Yep. Not enough to see him out of that eighth position. Pressure will be on his shoulders in the third round, and also on the shoulders of this man.
He just qualified for the Olympic Games on the very last day of qualification. Nothing like just, you know, getting the timing perfectly, but he's here and that's all that matters.
He's made the final.
Forever an Olympian, that's right.
Forever an Olympic finalist, Luis Mauricio da Silva. No improvement on 80-67. And it's really split into two groups here, this competition, in the second round.
Yeah, there's been a division there. Not quite what he wanted.
Oh. 78-67. More athlete to throw in this second round, a second round that has sparked life into this competition. Kiranen of Finland. An elite frog, his compatriot in eighth. The athlete currently in ninth and looking for something big. It seems like he likes the look of that, and maybe not. He got back up to his feet quickly, didn't he? And he had this look on his face. His eyes were wide and hopeful, and javelin went up and looped and back down.
Yeah, it almost had a little bit of spike up as it flew through. Not what he wanted.
So all three of the Finnish athletes under pressure going into the third round.
What do you think this guy's thinking right now? I just threw the biggest throw of my life. Set the Olympic record in my second throw. Wowza.
Probably something along those lines. You can't tell on his face though, can you? It's a huge personal best.
A lot of competition left.
Another Olympic record has fallen. History being made once again here at the Paris 2024 Olympic Games. Arshad Nedim.
Here.
Pressure is on that man. Neera Chopra.
Season best comes all the way, well, went before all the way back to April. Now tonight, Chopra has gotten his season best out there, so that has to feel good that he's timed this right.
He'll need also to throw a huge personal best. He'll need to throw over 90 meters for the first time, and it's not just over 90 meters. It's 92.97. We're talking incredibly close to 93 meters. He might even need a 93 meter plus throw to knock Arshad Nedim out of that gold medal berth that he currently occupies. We do take a pause as we wait for the track action to get underway and as the stadium bursts into voice once again. Jakub Vadlajk of Czechia. Well, he's improved on that first round throw. He'll need another improvement. He's been so consistent. Silver medalist in Tokyo, bronze medalist in the World Champs in 22, bronze medalist again in 2023, and looking to find a podium place here. It will it looks like it'll be another improvement. Will it be enough to see him into the medal positions? He will, of course, also be hoping in seventh position that he can steer away from the drop zone.
Oh, he looks a little bit more happy with that one. With that force behind it.
And he's done both. He's steered away from the drop and he's into the medal positions. Jakub Vadlajk, 88 metres 50. And up into third. Anderson Peters. Third round throw and a foot fault. Couldn't stay on his feet and he's over the line. And it took no time at all for the official to raise that red flag. Head from the athlete from Grenada.
Too much momentum going forward there. Tried to pull back and it just doesn't happen.
Well, the pressure is on and we've seen it before when in this games when the Olympic record's been taken down and it does send shockwaves through the whole group of athletes. Keshawn Walcott, who not long ago was occupying the top spot. We're around the 83-metre mark from Walcott.
Well, last year, having that Achilles injury at the World Championships, I think everybody's excited to have him back. He's done so much in this sport already.
Short of 83 meters, 82, 89. Arshad Nadim, well, how does he follow 92 meters, 97? It was such a surprise because he looked so out of sorts in that first throw. He couldn't make his way up the runway, he had to loop back down. He had one eye on the clock as well, and then out of nowhere in the second round, an Olympic record. Can he extend it here? The third round throw for Nadim. Shake of the head. As he knows what he's capable of. He's witnessed his own strength in the second round to take down the Olympic record. Adding over 2 meters to the Olympic record. It's an incredible feat. 88-72. Still one of the top three throws of the competition so far. Julian Weber. European silver medalist.
Family of handball players, which is awesome. It's kind of fun. So the twin sister. Everyone thinks it's fun when there's twins out there. He's got somebody cheering for him, regardless.
Weber on the runway. Whoa! Completely lost his footing there, and we won't even see where the javelin drops down. And particularly before that, I think he had a good feeling about it. He put so much power behind it, though, and
lucky he didn't turn that right ankle.
Well, exactly that. Frustration on the look of Weber. Best still, 87-33. Enough for sixth, as things stand. Remember, we will lose 8 athletes after this round. Julius Yego. Fifth, 87-72, the Kenyan. His third Olympic final. So experienced as he throws himself to the ground and tries to propel that javelin forward. And a throw, well, that won't be measured as the flag goes up. The season's best, that 87-72.
run-up looked good. He looked like he had smooth footwork there coming in. Just didn't get that power behind that element.
Lasse, Ete, Letalo.
A good one here.
It does indeed, because he's currently in 12th. And the mark he needs is his teammates. So if he can get over 82 meters 68, he'll push his compatriot out of eighth place. Screams, and well, there it is. It's enough to see him up and into at least eighth place. We'll wait for confirmation of where it's been measured, but the interesting thing is both Karanen and Helander will both have opportunities to come back.
He needed this.
Oh, it's going to be tight. It's enough for eighth place. 84-58 for Ete Latalo of Finland. And now it's a nervy wait. And that's the man who he's just knocked down. Helander was in that eighth position, now drops to ninth, but he will have an opportunity to respond, as will Karanen.
This man right here, Chopra, he's been staying away a little bit from competition. He said he just wanted to get here healthy. So he's been picking and choosing. He is healthy. There isn't an injury, but he was trying to play it uber safe this year.
He has so much support from the crowd, and he'll need to draw on it here. The athlete in second. Need to find a huge response at some point during this competition. And it won't be in the third round.
A little bit of a disappointment here so far for him. He's changed how Indian athletes think and train and believe in themselves. With that following that he has, he's done some great things. He's got a lot of pressure too.
A lot of eyes on him, and well, he's ranked number 2 in the world. No one really could have predicted that throw from Arshad Nadim. And now it's just how you respond to it. And that's something that you can't really train for. It's just something that you need to be able to respond to. You can't practice having to chase these huge throws that, for us, watching in, I'm sure Nadim kind of knew the form he was in. But for us, these surprise throws, the athletes, they have to figure out on the spot how they deal with it, how they react.
There's just so much force in the javelin. You can see ankles are tied up and taped. Elbows have elbow pads or sleeves, and they have so much torque. Bodies go through a lot.
They do indeed. And another occasion where we're just over halfway through now, this third round. The athletes have to put the blinkers on. And you can see keep himself in the zone. He had his head hung as he walked back. He's trying to block out the noise and the distractions of the track events going on around him. Currently in 12th position. He needs something bigger than 84-58 if he's to continue his journey here at the Paris Olympic Games, and it won't be enough, and that's the end of the road for the Moldovan athlete at his second Olympic Games. 7th in Tokyo, and he's not been able to match that here in Paris. Season's best in qualifying to make it through to the final, and he'll end with his best throw, 80 metres and 10.
Three
Oliver Hellander with an opportunity now to try and re-leapfrog his compatriot Taylor Salo. He needs 84.58 or bigger. Hollander, can he get back into eighth? No, and that's the end of his competition here in Paris. Oliver Hollander will finish with a best of 82.68.
Just loves the jab. Anyone that knows him knows how much he loves throwing in the competition.
And unfortunately for Hollander, it is his teammate, his compatriot, who has denied him a place in the top eight here in Paris. Ete Lotalo, his wait to see if he can be confirmed as that eighth position will have to continue as De Silva on the runway. And the Brazilian will go out. Disappointment on his face, no throw in the final round, his Olympic debut. First global final though, and something that I'm sure deep down he's incredibly proud of achieving.
He says he learned French to come to Paris. I mean, he has done everything to get here, qualified that last day, prepared by learning how to speak French. I mean, he's going to remember this for a lifetime, so he cannot hang his head.
A national record in qualifying as well. So only one man now can deny Ete Lotalo a place in the top eight, and that is his compatriot, his countryman, Tony Kiralainen. He's in 10th. He'll need an improvement of around 4 meters. Looks up wistfully, and he's unable to unseat his compatriot, who take a deep breath there, and he gave it everything in search of that eighth place and an improvement. Ete Lotalo of Finland, the only of the three Finnish athletes who will be progressing through to the top eight. Karan, and he took a big knock there as he went to the ground, his best 18.92. But Carrie, we love to see the athletes really giving it their everything, as much as it is hard to see them in pain there.
Yeah, he came down hard, but that was what he needed to do. He had to give it everything, put all of the strength he had behind it. And unfortunately, it wasn't enough.
So there's the standings after three rounds. We'll continue with just the top eight. Arshad Nadim, I'm sure we're all still recovering from that huge 92.97 meter throw, the Olympic record, a huge personal best. And how does Neerla Chopra, the reigning champion, respond? It's going to take something huge. It will take a big personal best from him if he's to obtain his medal here at the Olympic Games.
You know, the sport has changed so much. There's so much more going into, or at least the access to fueling and hydration and what they do in between. And you know, the exercise physiology of all of sport has just really helped with these huge throws, even though this world record has been from, what is it, 1996? I mean, it's about time we get a new world record out there.
That would be a huge shock tonight. Someone would have to do something.
I know.
That
it might not be
quite
tonight.
Frankly, unbelievable.
But come on, guys.
If you to put it into context, with that throw, Arshad Nadim has gone sixth on the all-time list.
Sixth.
Woo. So still, Anderson Peters, who's in this competition ahead of him, in fifth with 93 meters and seven. But Arshad Nadim now has the Olympic record. And if he can see out this competition with it intact, we have seen it be taken down and then taken down again in competitions already here at the Olympic Games. If he can see out this competition with it. It will stand for another 4 years.
Well, and Peters did that in 2022 when he threw his 93.07. So it's not like it's been that long. Mm-hmm. Things can happen, yes. The injuries is what he's had. But he knows it. He knows that he's thrown that far. That is a big thing to have in your mind. And to know that his body can do that. So, yeah, he's coming back, but he is super happy to be back. And now the pressure's on to see what can happen.
The challenge is doing it at an Olympic Games, though, and that's what Nadim has been able to do. That Olympic record was from 2008. So it had stood for quite some time. And it's always a different beast competing at an Olympic Games. As you know, Carrie, you can compete on the circuit all year round and you compete at World Championships, and the Olympic Games just feels a little bit different.
There's so much that goes into it. I mean, you're sleeping in different, you know, we're used to traveling and being in hotels, but when you're in the village, or nowadays there's a lot of athletes that prefer to be in Airbnbs or whatever, it's just getting used to all of it. And I can remember even doing my pre-race nap, you know, we take naps, and there was an earthquake at Greece. So, like, we have to deal with all these things, and it's so fun, though. I highly recommend.
If you can be one of the 1% to do it, Carrie Torlofsen strongly recommends it. And here's a man who's been able to continue his journey here at the Games. Etelä Salo of Finland. His compatriot's misfortune, his fortune, securing the eighth place, and he will now be the first to throw. Getting us underway in the fourth round, Etelä Salo of Finland. Well, 84.58 was the throw that unseated his teammate, and that won't quite reach those kinds of heights. It's always interesting to see how an athlete responds to almost being knocked out. Sometimes they really gather that adrenaline and use it for some big throws, some big jumps in the fourth round. We've seen it plenty of times, and, well, that's no improvement.
A kick in the pants is what I like to call it. We all need them at times.
Well, how the competition has turned for Keshawn Walcott.
Very young.
Second.
When he won his gold, right?
Indeed. Doing the double with the World Under 20 Championships in the same year, it's almost unheard of.
It just doesn't seem like he's, you know, happy with any of his throws tonight.
Well, he had that first throw of 86.16, and we thought that would be something to build, and he was the only athlete to throw a big throw in the first round, and then the competition's just sort of gotten away from him as these big throws have started to come through, and he's dropped from first down to seventh, and there'll be no improvement there. That 86.16, though, a season's best. Just shows when you look at the season's best that have been set up and down this field, it just shows the quality of competition. Is Julian Weber, ranked number 3 in the world, the German.
I love his run up. He's got some great footwork. Gets his knees up, chops those steps. He has to be able to control it. We haven't seen his control yet tonight.
Julian Weber of Germany. And you'll have to take that back. You can see the clock. He's permitted to have another go at his run-up, as long as he hasn't, of course, crossed the line and released the javelin. As long as it's within that time, and you can see the clock ticking down, he'll be under pressure here. 10 seconds. He needs to get moving, does Julian Weber. Just in the nick of time. And, well, that's not too bad for Weber. 87 33 is his only clean throw of the competition.
He knew it when he stood up, but waiting on that final confirmation. Coming in with an 88.37 for the season's best. Let's see if he...
Well, it will be short of that. Yeah. It's 86.85. And for someone who's, well, he just missed out on a medal in Tokyo, he's come so close, and he will have hated the idea of seeing a medal slip away from him again. But the competition just turned completely in the second round, and the kind of distances we're looking at now to secure a medal, you really have to be on top of your game here. Julius Jäger knows what it takes to win big on the global stage. He's in fifth with 87.33. Can he improve in the fourth round? No, just fractionally short of 85 metres. The pressure is on here. You need a really big throw to perform.
Diego is a full-time athlete, but also a police officer back in Kenya. It'd be awesome that he devotes his time to service also to his country to do these great things on the track.
4 meters 90. Former world champion, he's now 35 years old. He's gone over 92 meters. 92, 72, but that was back in 2015. Anderson Peters. His personal best and national record, a lot more recent, 2022. Two-time world champion. He was in fourth, and that is very close to the marker you see on your screen, the bronze indicating that third place.
Look at that long open stride that he had, really getting his feet under him.
Well, this is going to be very close with Jakub Vadlajc's 88.50. Where will it come in? 88.54. So Anderson Peters up into third. Well, very much like we've seen in the men's discus and the men's hammer, we have these little battles behind the standout performer. Those battles for the medal. And can Vadlajc respond? He can't, because once again his foot is out of bounds. His first no throw, but we've seen plenty of athletes fall to that red flag, just the tip of your toes over, and the official will lift the red flag.
God, like, really proud of his age and that he's in one of the older athletes. He's still very much younger athlete in my book, but really cool that he is still finding joy in the sport and loving to stay in it.
So consistent, medaled at three of the last four world championships, reigning European champion.
The crowd getting into it, knowing that he is up next.
Yep, Neera Chopra. Here he goes. In the silver medal position, the athlete from India, the reigning champion, and it looked like his heel was out anyway, and, well, he'll shuffle over the line. That's two no throws in a row. He's only had one clean throw this competition. And, well, Kerry, how do you get out of a rut mentally when you know you're chasing something big, but also you're seeing these no throws and these faults start to appear within your own competition?
I think a lot of times a coach or an athlete will just say, let's loosen up here, have a little bit of fun. This is one of his buddies out here. They're just out here doing what they love to do. Yes, they are on the biggest stage, but when it is getting too serious, they get tight, they think too much, they don't just use their instinct, and it doesn't go the way we want a lot of times when we get too into it. So hopefully he can just loosen up a little bit, have a bit of fun, throw a smile on. A smile goes a long ways when you're really kind of stressing out. This is the guy to watch right now.
This is the man who's throwing with a smile. He's throwing relaxed and with an extra air of confidence because he's broken the Olympic record already tonight.
Don't get me wrong, you can have as much fun in the world and be happy and be very serious. I just sometimes think you have to loosen up.
He'll be throwing relaxed. Arshad Nadim of Pakistan. And that, well, there was a lot going on. You can see behind him as the athletes for the track event are starting to prepare. And it's on that top bend as well. And that's an extra thing that earlier on in the session, the track athletes were further down at the 200 meter start. And now they've moved where he'll be doing his run up.
Yeah, just seeing the hurdles on the track and just having different vision around or different things going on around you. Your vision isn't quite 100% on, so I'm not surprised to see him not have his best throw there.
Well, still holds two of the top three best throws in this competition. And one of those is the new Olympic record. As we now head into the penultimate round of throws. Taylor Talo, previous European medalist. Slides over the line on his knees.
Really released that pretty far back. We'll take a look here. Just like grimace of the teeth. Definitely not the throw that he wanted.
Sean Walcott. Right, just inside of the top 10, ninth in the world this year. This 6:16, his best from the first round. And things just haven't clicked for him after that.
Boundaries, but not what he wanted. A little bit flat.
'76, '86 His season's best, his best performance in this competition still. 86-16 from the first round. Julian Weber, Aurora, a slap of the biceps.
There he goes.
He's talking himself up for this one.
Yep, getting fired up. We know that this man loves to cook. He also loves to dance. You can see that he's got that light, fast rhythm when he comes into his throw. Can he's trying to get pumped.
He needs to hype himself up here. He needs to find something big, and he needs to block out everything else that's going on around him. He left it so late in the last round to start his run-up. Of Germany. A dismissive look, but it's not too bad. He's in sixth. He needs bigger than 87-72 to leap up into fifth. Climb up a position. He needs anything over 88-54 for a medal, and it looked short of the markers that you could see on the graphics, and it's 87-40. An improvement, but no change of position for Julian Weber.
Still smiling. Still there encouraging others. Here's Diego. We have it.
Currently in fifth.
A We've seen it before where someone has launched a big one. Here he goes.
Diego of Kenya on the runway, gearing up. High and looping once again. An athlete with so much experience in global finals.
With that ankle, I mean, I'm wondering if his run-up is just not quite as fast, as powerful. He has that big brace on his ankle. Not limping, but might not just be quite what he wants.
And there's the new Olympic record holder, Arshad Nadim, going through his processes.
Putting your sweats back on. So important to make sure that you don't waste any of that energy by trying to stay warm.
No, completely, and it's a huge stadium. It's been a couple of really warm weeks in Paris, but also it's a stadium where the wind can pick up quite a lot and change direction. You can get quite caught out in it, and particularly when the sun begins to set, it can get quite chilly in the Stade de France. Is having to wait before he can throw.
Visualization, the self positive talk.
And he wants to keep his momentum going here because that improvement in the fourth round, 88-54, a 4-centimeter gap between him and Jakub Vadlajc of Czechia. Like ranked number one in the world this year, and won't want to let a global medal slip away when he's had so much success on the world stage recently, and he's trying to keep that podium streak going. And 4 years back to back it will be if he can find something here. Chopra is also in the same kind of vein of form and consistency. Nadim.
Regrouping here. Crowd's going wild. Calm himself. Get back into his mindset.
St. Peters, his time has come in the fourth round, the fifth round now, his penultimate throw. No improvement on 88-54. 87-38 for Anderson Peters of Grenada. Still in third place. And that was occupied by Jakub Vadlajc of Czechia. Vadlajc. Just keeps his toes in. Short of 85. So it will come down to the final round for Jakub Vadlajc if he's to barge his way into the medal position. He's going to need to because there's so little between him and Anderson Peters at the minute.
And I sort of love the last throw.
The last round is going to be spicy.
You know, when an athlete just wants to give it everything they have, it sometimes is what you need. Never count anyone out in the last round.
Well, you can't at all. Arshad Nadim waits patiently. Here, Chopra. Those trademark final stretches. Yeah. He's such a flexible athlete.
Gonna all have their thing, right?
He's being willed on. He will be the centre of attention within this cauldron that is the Stade de France. What can the reigning champion do in the penultimate round? And his legs are over, and he really is in this rut. Three now foul throws in a row for Chopra. One more attempt to try and beat the Olympic record. The task is so great for Neeraj Chopra if he's to retain his gold medal. He can't see it as something that's beginning to slip away from him. He can't let that mindset sneak in. But it is something. It is an accolade that is starting to slip from his grasp as Arshad Nadeem. The dream of becoming Olympic champion is beginning to be realised. And it won't just be Olympic champion. It will likely be the Olympic record holder. He already is. He's well on his way to finishing this competition in the history books, and with a gold medal hung around his neck. And you heard the ring of the bell in the background there, the bells that will be heading off to Notre Dame Cathedral as part of the refurbishments. And it will take something very special indeed in the final round to stop it being anyone other than Arshad Nadeem, the new Olympic record holder, from ringing the bell. Eight throws to go. Eight men still in this competition.
Imagine ringing that bell.
It's such a stunning piece of, well, it will become a huge part of the refurbishments of Notre Dame, and such a vital part and such a key part of history in Paris. And well, I love the idea of ringing a bell, like the PB bells that we see, you know, all around, particularly on races and, you know, track races, road races. There's that PB bell, and well,
I like that.
It gives the athletes this extra thing, and I love that it's unique to Paris.
Yep.
And I also would like to see it continue.
I also love that everyone rings it differently.
Mm.
You know? You want to say they beat to their own drum, but they actually ring to their own bell.
They do indeed. Right, here's a look at some of the markers. We actually haven't seen those yet for our javelin throwers. We've seen them on a number of occasions for our jumpers. And again, something that's unique to Paris. They've got their own design on. Unique to the Paris 2024 Olympic Games. As Lasse Etelä-Talo of Finland came in as one of three Finnish athletes to make it to the final. It's a huge achievement and a huge testament of the standard of throwing in Finland. He's the only one to remain after knocking his own teammate out of the eighth position in the third round. A no throw in the fifth. This his final throw. Lasse Etelä-Talo of Finland. 84-58, his best on final throw. Over 80 metres, it won't be over 84-58. And a round of applause for Lasse Etelä-Talo, who acknowledges the crowd, a previous European medalist who, well, he hasn't quite come into the form that he'd want to see himself hitting ahead of this Games, but he's made the top eight of an Olympic final. And that will be down on his record forever.
You gave it everything, though. He stayed in it. You could tell from the very first couple throws that he was a little bit frustrated, a little bit quiet, a little bit subdued. But he stuck in it.
Walcott opting to not throw in this final round. So that's the end of the road for Keshawn Walcott. Passing in the final round, so he'll finish in seventh. We hope that that's not due to injury. Julian Weber of Germany, currently in sixth. One final throw for the European silver medalist, fourth in Tokyo. One last big push for Julian Weber of Germany. Short of 85 metres and a shake of the head from the German. His third Olympic final.
Three-time Olympian. This man does not need to be disappointed. I know that we all want the hardware, but when he goes through life and he says, I'm not just one time, I'm two times. Oh, wait, no, I'm three. Maybe even he'll be back for four. You never know. That is an awesome feat, and he should be proud of himself.
Just soaking it all up with Vadlike. There's Julius Jäger, former medalist in the silver in 2016. Improved on his season's best in this competition. 87-72, that season's best and his best in the competition. Of applause, and he's fought so hard to get to these championships.
Yeah.
And he'll be, well, so proud of his achievements.
I just don't think he didn't have that foot planted. I don't think that foot has the strength that it needs. If it truly is coming back from a bit of an injury, that's too critical.
But these athletes will do absolutely everything to get to these games, and he's finished in fifth place. So honorable. The 35-year-old, former world champion, his fourth Olympic Games, his third Olympic final, and he can soak it all up and know it's an achievement that he can be proud of. Jakub Vadlike in fourth. Silver medalist from Tokyo. Well, he needs to find 4 centimetres. In all likelihood, looking at the scorecards, he'll probably need to find 5, equaling 88.54. Will not be enough. He needs to go over that. He needs a big throw in the final round if he's to get himself into the medal positions. Vadlike stays on his feet, and it won't be enough. It'll be a fourth place finish for Jakub Vadlike of Czechia, who acknowledges the crowd and thanks them for their support. The medals are set. What order, what colour, will be decided in the next two throws.
Oprah has to be feeling the pressure right now. He has not had a throw since his second round, so he needs to kind of get regroup in this competition and see what he's got. Peters, though, the man that came in with the biggest throw.
He will be next to throw. He has a huge personal best, but it's been 2 years since he set that national record of 93 meters and 7. One final throw for Anderson Peters. Can he improve his gold medal? He can't. It will be a bronze medal for Anderson Peters of Grenada, the two-time world champion.
Quite the CV.
Another global accolade. And in another incredibly high quality field final. So, the reigning champion, Neeraj Chopra, ranked number 2 in the world, only one clean throw, 89-45, and he calls on the crowd, Neeraj Chopra, for support, and the crowd will get behind him here.
And all 9 million plus will be behind him. Here he goes.
Such a great sporting rivalry between Pakistan and India. And the reigning champion on the runway for one final throw. He hasn't looked convinced with any of his throws so far. That face has so regularly just been blank as he's thrown it. And it will be a silver medal for the returning champion, who can't make it 2 in the row. He would have needed to demolish the Olympic record, because Arshad Nadeem, in the second round, threw a huge 92-97, and he is the Olympic champion here in Paris. He's the Olympic record holder. And he will have one final throw. He secured the gold. His Olympic record will be untouched for another 4 years. Unless he can improve it in the final round. It's a throw of honour. The crowd behind him, it's a big throw. It won't improve the Olympic record. But he's been so consistent, and no throw in the first round, and since then, every single one of his throws have been clean. He waits on to see where this will be measured.
It was a big throw though too.
It was a big throw. Over 90 meters once again, and it would have broken the Olympic record from 2008 if he hadn't done it already in the second round. Two huge throws. What a performance. Arshad Nadeem of Pakistan, your new Olympic champion and Olympic record holder. Two throws over 90 meters. Throws, one gold medal, one Olympic record, the first gold medal in athletics for Pakistan.
See him keep his eyes down just for a second as he let that jab go, and then he looked up and he knew it was big again. Not quite as big as that Olympic record second round throw, but another big one. And just look at this emotion. Lots of thank yous to the guys around him. And everyone in the crowd is excited, including
those. It's brilliant
those.
To watch, isn't it?
Yeah, they care and love him so much.
Three of the top 4 biggest throws in this competition have been his. He's been consistent, and he's been rewarded with the Olympic medal, the gold medal, and the Olympic record.
And he's sitting there, I'm sure, just thinking, what in the world? Now I will forever be an Olympic champ. And if that record stands that long, you'll be an Olympic record holder for many, many years.
Neeraj Chopra couldn't make it back-to-back Olympic titles. He has to settle for silver. Only one clean throw in the competition, and still has to wait to break that elusive 90-meter mark. Anderson Peters, a 2-time world champion, and now an Olympic bronze medalist. Well, another high quality long throws final here at the Paris 2024 Olympic Games, and another Olympic record tumbles. It's been an incredible night of competition here in the Stade de France. And once again, the field events really being given the respect and the attention that they deserve. That was the moment. Well, he knew he was crowned Olympic champion and Olympic record holder before that, but to have two throws over 90 metres in one competition, it just shows the levels that Arshad Nadim has hit in this men's javelin throw final. Pakistan take the gold, their first ever gold medal in the athletics in the men's javelin throw final, and it's Arshad Nadim who beats Neeraj Chopra, who came into this as the reigning champion of India. He settles for silver, and Anderson Peters of Grenada takes the bronze medal.
He really got this competition started with that big throw. Everyone had to follow suit, but they just didn't have it tonight. You know, the way he started this competition with having to restart his run-up, and that can really cause some negativity to go on in your mind and just to, you know, lose that zip that you need. But he didn't let that bother him.
No, he really lit up this competition. It was a really tentative first round of throws, and we looked at Nadim. He was a man who's thrown over 90 meters before this competition. His season's best wasn't up there amongst those who we'd pinpoint before as favorites for a medal. And that really hesitant first throw that was then marked as a no throw to come out one round later and throw a personal best of well over 2 meters and throw over 5 meters more than you have this season is just incredible and something, well, it caught us all out. As you can see, our medalists, yep, with their flags hung around their shoulders gathering for the photos. That's your podium here in Paris.
A lot of camaraderie there. Spend a lot of time dreaming together, believing in each other, pushing each other. That's what it's all about.
Chopra would have had high expectations of himself coming into this final, but a silver medal. And now 4 global championships where he's finished on a podium in a row.
Wow.
And he'll have an opportunity again to do it next summer, such as the global fixture congestion that we've seen as we come back and get back on track after the pandemic. And of course, for the first time since the pandemic in an Olympic Games, crowds back in the stands and a beautiful moment.
Isn't that
for
great?
The new Olympic record holder, the new Olympic champion, Arshad Nadim of Pakistan, holding his country's flag high as he makes history here in Paris.
It is so electrifying in the stadium. It is so loud at times, and it is deafening at times. Mm. How quiet it can be, you know, it is just amazing where it is. Almost, I can't believe how loud the silence is. It's really cool.
And those sort of ebbs and flows in terms of the sound from the stadium is something that the athletes have to contend with, and they have to respond to. And the person who responded best to the noise, the excitement, everything going on around him was Arshad Nadim. As the action concludes, both on the track and in the field, an opportunity now for the athletes to really enjoy these moments. And you can see it really starting to settle in now for Nadim. When he was packing his bag up, he was, you know, he didn't do a victory lap. He didn't jump up initially and grab the flag. And now you can see as the competition has ended. It's really, and he's had time to see his friends, his family, his coaching staff, his support team, and he now goes on the victory lap.
He better get over to that bell too, right?
They'll be queuing up.
Yeah, take this moment in. He deserves it.
Well, how great is it to see field events celebrated in this way, and the fans have turned out in the stadiums and in the stands, and the action in the centre of the track has more than delivered. Olympic records falling left, right and centre.
They all should feel so proud. You know, getting here is just such a feat. No matter if you are a returning Olympic gold medalist or a first-time Olympian, it is tough to put it all together, make those teams regardless of how they're chosen, and to get on that runway in the ring. It'll be a real nice exhale in a few minutes here for all of these athletes that, you know, they're still hyped up, but just to be able to think, oh, okay.
Adrenaline.
I don't want to say Paris is done, but for some of these athletes, they can now start thinking about the next thing, because that four-year cycle is a long time.
Four-year cycle is an incredibly long time, and we haven't quite had a four-year cycle because we've had 3 years, so now it will be the start of a four-year cycle looking towards LA. And
see? Every country out there, they're all representing. They're all so excited.
Light show around the top of the Stade de France is, well, how nice is it to see the fans stay in and celebrate?